Students, let us start the problem. The problem says a block of mass M lying on a horizontal surface. The block of mass M lying on a horizontal surface whose coefficient of friction between the surface and the block is mu s. This mu s is the coefficient of friction. Obviously, it is the coefficient of static friction, and this block is to be brought into motion. So this block has to be in motion by a pulling force F. So this block is on the surface and it is pulled by a force with certain angle with the horizontal. At what angle theta with horizontal the force F be applied so that its magnitude is minimum? What is the basic meaning of this? That there is a block and you are pulling the block with certain angle with the horizontal. You are not pulling straight, you are pulling with certain angle with the horizontal, and you are applying a minimum force. So it says that if I apply minimum force, then at what angle I should apply the minimum force? Okay. Suppose that I should apply 30 degree, 20 degree, or 60 degree, at what angle I should apply the force so that the block starts moving. So you have to find a force that is minimum and with what angle that is applied so that the block starts moving. Now, to solve this question, first let us draw a block. This is a block and it is kept on this horizontal surface. This has friction value mu s. Now, I apply a force in the direction, say like this. This is the force that I am applying, and with certain angle, say theta. So this is the angle that I am applying the force, and I have to determine for what angle theta this force is minimum, and also I have to find the magnitude. So that magnitude is minimum, so I have to find that magnitude of that force. So what I will do is a block mass M. So, I have to draw a free body diagram. Its weight will be, the normal direction will be upward. This is the normal direction which is acting upward direction. F is theta, so this is F cos theta. If I reserve the force, applied force in these two components, this will be F cos theta and this is F sin theta. Okay. Now, I'll just take another page for this. Now, as this has to move, I'll just write the balance equation. In the vertical direction, when the block starts moving, there is no movement, so I'll write the just balance the upward force and the downward force. So the upward force will be the normal direction, and the component of the force that I have applied, that will be also in the upward direction. So these two forces in the upward direction will add up and will balance the weight of the block. So the normal direction plus F sin theta, component of the applied force acting in the upward direction, must balance the weight of the mass. Now from here I can write that M equals to mg minus F sin theta. I can rewrite this equation like this because I am interested in my normal direction, so I write the normal direction in this form. Next is, what about the force which is responsible for the motion? The horizontal motion that is taking place for the block is because of the applied force component F cos theta. So F cos theta is applied in the direction, and obviously because of the friction will oppose the relative motion, and that will be the vector direction, and that is minus of mu s L. This is the difference, and that will provide me M into A. What is A? A is the acceleration. So these two, if the block has to move in the forward direction, then this would be the equation. Now, I said that just start sliding, so therefore I would say for just writing the acceleration is zero. If I write acceleration of block zero, because the block will start sliding just if you apply a little push to it and it starts moving. That means it is the case when your applied force component and the frictional force that opposes the relative motion balance each other out. So for to find the minimum value of applied force responsible for the motion, you have to equate this force with this force. So I'll make this acceleration zero. If I do so, I'll get F cos theta is mu s into n. And in place of n, I'll substitute this value. To substitute this value of n is over here, I'll write mu s . This is what I am going to get it. Okay. Now, after you get this, our aim is to find the minimum force responsible for this motion. Then I will first separate this F out. So this will become F cos theta. This is how you separate this. Then you bring this to this side. So if this is brought to that side, I'll write F common. Mu s sin theta because f is common and this is mg. So this is the force and I'll write this force is mu s mg divided by cos theta plus mu s sin theta. Now mu s is a dimensionless quantity, and this mu s can be replaced for simplification with some tangent of certain angle. So if I replace this mu s by tan of say any angle say phi, for simplicity, if I substitute, this is for simplification. I substitute this over here and I will get what? I will get is mu s is tan phi mg divided by cos theta . So I got this. Now I can write tan phi as sin phi over cos phi. So this is sin phi over cos phi, this is sin phi over cos phi, and taking the LCM, this cos phi will get cancelled and here one cos phi will multiply and here it will be sin phi. So this will become mg sin phi divided by cos theta cos phi plus sin theta sin phi sin theta sin phi. Now now, if I look this, then I can, so, now, this cos theta cos phi plus sin theta sin phi is cos theta minus phi. Cos A minus B is cos A cos B n minus, plus of sin A sin B. Therefore, this is mg sin phi divided by cos theta minus phi. Cos theta minus phi. Now, this is the force. And we want the force, this force is responsible for the motion, but what do we want? We want the force to be minimum. For the force to be minimum, in this numerator and denominator you see, then this force is minimum if this is maximum. If this is maximum, this fraction will be minimum and the force will be minimum. So, what I will do, I will take the maximum value of cos theta minus phi. For F to be minimum, your cos theta minus phi should be maximum. And what is the maximum value of cos theta minus phi? Is 1. And with what angle this is possible? 0. That means this implies that theta is equal to phi. Theta is equal to phi. So, if I put theta equals to phi, or then that means
these two will become 0 and cos theta is 1, and therefore f is minimum. So f minimum is found to be mg sin phi. Whether you write phi or write theta, that is the same thing. So mg sin phi. Now, that force which is minimum is mg sine of phi, okay, and you can also write this as mg mu s divided by 1 plus mu s square the root. This also can be written that way. So finally f minimum is found to be this. So this is the minimum force which is applied at an angle of theta, so for the block to be in motion. Okay, so this is the answer to that question. Okay, thank you very much.